Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. The topic in this video is about mixing two objects at different temperatures. You will learn how to find the final temperature of the mixture, assuming that there is no heat loss from the system. In this video, we shall discuss three examples of mixture: liquid-liquid, liquid-solid, and solid-solid. Recall that for an object of mass m and specific capacity c, if the temperature change is delta t, the heat exchange q is given by c equal to q divided by m divided by delta t, or q equal to m times c times delta t. Suppose we have two liquids A and B with masses mA and B, specific capacity cA cB, and initial temperature TA TB respectively. Assume that A is hotter than B, that is TA is greater than TB. Now pour the two liquids into an empty polystyrene cup. Let's assume that there is no heat loss from the system. Also, the final temperature is T. The magnitude of change in temperature of A is TA minus T, and that of B is T minus TB. The heat loss by A is Q loss equal to MA times CA times TA minus T. The heat gain by B is Q gain equal to MB times CB times T minus TB. By conservation of energy, Q loss equal to Q gain. We have the following equation with the only unknown T. This enables us to find the final temperature T of the mixture. Let's look at a numerical example. Example 1. 2 kg of oil at 90 degrees Celsius is mixed with 3 kg of oil at 20 degrees Celsius. Given that the specific capacity of oil and water are 3000 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius and 4200 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius respectively, find the temperature of the mixture. Let T be the final temperature. Heat loss by oil is Q loss equal to MA times CA times TA minus T equal to 2 times 3000 times 90 minus T. And heat gain by water is Q gain equal to MB times CB times T minus TB equal to 3 times 4200 times T minus 20. By conservation of energy, Q loss equal to Q gain, we have 90 minus T equal to 2.1 times T minus 20. The final temperature is T equal to 132 divided by 3.1 equal to 42.58 or 42.6 degrees Celsius. Now, let's look at the mixture of a solid and a liquid. Example 2. An aluminum block of mass 500 g at temperature 100 degrees Celsius is immersed into a cup of water of mass 300 g at 20 degrees Celsius. Given that the specific capacities of aluminium and water are 900 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius and 4200 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius respectively, find the temperature of the mixture. Let T be the final temperature. Heat loss by the aluminium block is Q loss equal to MA times CA times TA minus T equal to 0.5 times 900 times 100 minus T. And heat gain by water is Q gain equal to MB times CB times T minus TB equal to 0.3 times 4200 times T minus 20. Assume no heat loss to the surrounding. By conservation of energy, Q loss equal to Q gain, we have 100 minus T equal to 2.8 times T minus 20. The final temperature is T equal to 41 degrees Celsius. Finally, let's consider the mixture of two solid objects. Example 3. An iron block of mass 2 kg at 80 degrees Celsius is placed in contact with another iron block of mass 5 kg at 10 degrees Celsius. Find the final temperature of the combination. Let T be the final temperature of the combination. Also, let C be the heat capacity of iron. Heat loss by the hot iron block is Q loss equal to 2 times C times 80 minus T. Heat gain by the cold iron block is Q gain equal to 5 times C times T minus 10. Again, assume no heat loss to the surroundings. By conservation of energy, we have 2 times C times 80 minus T equal to 5 times C times T minus 10. We have 180 minus 2T equal to 5T minus 50. Therefore, 7T equal to 210. So the final temperature of the combination is T equal to 30 degrees Celsius. The temperatures of the two blocks change with time as shown in the graph. In summary, you have learned how to find the temperature T of a mixture by assuming that there is no heat loss to the surroundings. The method is to write down the heat loss by the hot one and the heat gain by the cold one. Then we can set up an equation with T as the only variable. As a result, T can be found by solving the equation. Questions. Question 1. Suppose 100 g of water at 90 degrees Celsius is mixed with 200 g of water at 20 degrees Celsius. Find the temperature of the mixture. State the assumption you have made in your calculation. Question 2. We have already learned about an experiment to measure the specific heat capacity of aluminium by heating it with an immersion heater. However, this experiment is far from perfect and the result has a considerably large experimental error. Can you design an experiment using mixture to measure the specific capacity of aluminium? Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. I hope this video can help you understand more about finding the temperature of a mixture. Thank you for watching.